I knew there was a George there, but I...
I'll talk to you.
Well, again, glad to have this opportunity now with you all again to have some discussion on a few things that are going on. We're going to Geneva, as you know, and I have to tell you, I'm going with a sense of confidence and optimism, but not because I have any illusions about Soviet intentions and the fundamental differences between us, but the one thing that over and with your help and support, we're going there for the first time in a long time with strength supporting us, and we're going to take advantage of that when we get there. We're bringing a broad agenda to Geneva, focusing on the full spectrum of our relations. It isn't just going to be there to argue about some proposal regarding arms cuts, although arms cuts are going to be very definitely a part of it, but all the regional conflicts and the bilateral relationships are, we're not going to make any artificial linkage of all of these. Human rights and everything else, it's all going to be there because I think the main purpose is if in some way we can begin to whittle away at the distrust and the suspicions that exist between us, the other thing will follow. The key objective of meeting Gorbachev will be to chart a realistic course for further discussions among negotiators after Geneva. And George, Bud, as you know, were in Moscow earlier this week, and we're going to give you a report on their talks. We have confirmed that we face a difficult negotiating task, I'm sure. And I wish to stress that we don't view Geneva as an end in itself, but rather a key part of an ongoing process. Your continued advice and support is of great importance. We need to show the Soviets that we stand together in support of our democratic values, respect for human rights as a basis for our policies around the world. But now that's enough out of me. I'm going to call on George and maybe Bud if he wishes to.
Thank you very much. I'll have a chance to read each one of them individually when, before we leave here today, but I understand right now that the press is going to come in.
About 30 seconds for them to Thank you, gentlemen.
If you won't think me sacrilegious, just having this photo opportunity here in mind is something supposed to have been said at Last Supper. Anyone who wants to get in the picture, get on this side of me. I saw Jim turn. Bud McFarland leave here. I hope he didn't think all the chairs were filled. Well, if I could just for a few moments here, I see our trip to Geneva as a potential starting point for better relations between our two countries. I'm going to remain optimistic and believe it. Still happen, but
and realistic at the same time. We know our adversary will not grant us any favors, and we know his record on protecting fundamental human rights. But you, the leaders of various denominations of the Christian faith and Jewish leaders who are here, this is appropriate in our Judeo-Christian tradition, and I don't have to educate any of you on the Soviet record on religious rights. In fact, I'm looking forward to hearing your suggestions on how we may be able to affect some progress on that. I intend to talk to Mr. Gorbachev about it. But let me assure you that when I meet with him, the issue of religious persecution and human rights in general will be very high on my list, along with regional issues, bilateral matters, and arms control and security. These two have important moral dimensions. Our Strategic Defense Initiative, for example, is intended to protect life rather than to destroy it or even threaten it. And if we can get the Soviet Union to recognize the merits of moving in this direction together, we will have made an important step on the path to a safer future. There's been a little confusion about what I mean with our Strategic Defense Initiative. It isn't a weapon, it is a shield, a space shield, in which we hope that our research will lead us to a system that will enable us to intercept nuclear missiles before they reach their target. But if and when that research indicates something of that kind is possible, it is my dream that before we suddenly rush ahead, claim possession and deploy it, that we sit down with all the other nuclear powers of the world, including the Soviet Union, and tell them that now we have the answer to eliminating nuclear weapons, and that if all will join in doing that, we'll make that weapon system, or that defensive system, available to all. And I'd like it a little bit to, like in Geneva, when after World War I we outlawed poison gas. Everybody kept their gas mask. Well, everyone would have this defense system in the event that someday a madman would come along and reinstitute those weapons we've done away with. We can't take away from men's minds the knowledge of how to make those weapons. So this would be our gas mask in a sense from here on out. But I appreciate this opportunity to break bread with you. And having been in a profession in which we often teased each other about being invited to lunch or dinner, but having to perform for our meal and not knowing which segment of our faiths that I could call upon for this, if you'll forgive me as a layman, would you permit me to ask the Lord's blessing?
Amen.
Dear God, thank thee for this gathering. Thank for the opportunity that you have given each one of us to serve you. Bless this food to our use. We thank thee for it. Dear God, we thank thee for the beauty of this earth that you have given us. In the Lord's name, amen.
Amen.
There.
It's original. It keeps saying for us.
It is done.
Thank you. We have a presentation to make to you, Mr. President. I guess the other day you had some of your supporters come in based upon your 4 more years in office. And we want you to know that it's 4 years of encouragement that you've given to us. So we want to present this little clock.
Ooh.
And the inscription is to President Ronald Reagan, in gratitude for your timely encouragement at the Alzheimer's Disease Association.
Well, thank you very much. That's very handsome. Thank you.
That got stopped by Secret Service, of course.
Well, of course it was ticking. Well, thank you very much. That's very handsome. take that upstairs.
Well, we certainly have been encouraged by the public awareness. This kind of thing has given us great encouragement because of the public awareness created. As we go back into our hometowns, into our various districts, and they know that your stamp of approval is on our association.
The last and the research years, how much clearly has been improved, but it's still not enough.
Government?
It's 56 million, and it should be 350
we're up to 50 million dollars.
I know there's a budget deficit.
Yeah, we do have some problems.
I know. Dental research is 44 million.
Well, you see, I don't have all the private because we
can't get the
fourth reason. I'd say with all the last one,
centers.
Yes, tremendous.
It's a good
beginning. Started 5 years ago when you went to the valley in the first year. With your help. That's right.
Well, you helped us a lot. We went from 1 day to 1 week, and now it's the month of November. It's Alzheimer's Awareness Month, so that's quite a jump. And I wish you lots of luck in
the summit.
Thank you.
Lots of luck.
Thank you very much.
Yes. Thank you.
And congratulations on the Achille Laura. That was the greatest thing you could have done.
There's one advantage about having my age now, this thing I'm looking forward to. At some point or other in the negotiations, you're going to be saying, go to a kid, look.
Thank you for seeing this. I'm proud of my carried the flag and brother Rat, so. I took you down the field.
You know, we're still being seen.
Yes, sir.
As I found out, now I have two movies that go on. At Notre Dame, they play the Rocky film for the incoming freshman class every year. And at BMI, a cadet just yesterday told me that every year they show Brother Rat at the BMI.
You and I had the right uniforms on that.
BMI says that West Point is the Virginia Military Institute of the North. Well, hey, bless you. Good to see you again.
Thank you so much for seeing us.
Well, listen, it's a pleasure.
Thank you again.
God bless you for all that you're carrying on and doing. Thank you.
Are you taking his bill with us? Are you taking his bill with us?
That's the official
bill.
The
official bill.
Oh, that's the official bill. It's entered into the records.
Happy to grab
that's
out.
Law. That's now law.
I hope you'll sign the NIH authorization. I hope you haven't. You didn't, huh?
I'm afraid they've got some things in it. Basically, I suppose some of the things in there might be trying to do administratively. But they loaded it up with some things that the property belongs. And yes. And it would find the. As we find the Congress literally is playing doctor and having just micromanagement over so many details that I think we just make the plain that what it is we do agree with and what we're trying to do. How they loaded it up.
Is it being sent back for amendment? Is it being sent back for amendment?
Well, I can't do that. I have to send it back.
You have to send it back.
And tell them disapproval.
That's the line item.
Yes.
Well, here's another example. It's a perfect.
If they give the president what every governor has, line item veto, I could assign that bill and simply veto line item down. These additions.
And then they could overwrite it.
If they feel strong enough, they can do
it.
In California, in 8 years, I line itemed 943 times without ever once being overridden. They would put the things in, but if they had to face standing up, would that just expose by itself? They didn't dare vote for it. You know, if it's something that you've got to find bill like that to get it passed by sneaking it in, then there must be something wrong with it.
I don't see any reason for avoiding that. We'll have to get back to you in an amended format.
Thank you
again,
Mr.
President. I've much push telling you now I have misunderstood.
Thank you.
Oysters for being orange juice.
hearing difficulties that I have. Orange juice sounded to me like oysters. I told her, pass it on to you. It's amazing the things I've heard. That word there.
Well, you know, both of us, since we're both raised, we can talk about this. Is the